So I spoke with a veteran special effects supervisor tonight, and he raised some interesting questions about the Changeling's creature, which made me ask myself, just how alien is my own creature? This is the 15th installment of the 90-day vlog marathon for Changelings in the run-up to the crowdfunding effort, which will begin on April 21st on Fundition and the Steam platform. I wanted to relay a bit of conversation that I had with a veteran special effects supervisor tonight. He's worked on projects like Passion of the Christ, that's kind of a big movie, and the special effects in that movie are outstanding. I remember wanting to puke in the theater when Jesus is getting his back whipped by the Cat of Nine Tails. Just excruciating, exquisite effects. And so it was great to have his perspective on Changelings. And when we were talking about the creature, he raised a really interesting question. The creature obviously doesn't have any bones, right? When he asked that question, I realized, oh, I need to think deeper about the biology of the creature, not only how it behaves during transformation, but how does it behave and operate when it's just operating normally, when you know, this guy or our character is going about its business. You know, he pitched out a really wild idea, which was maybe it's like a crab, that it's a sort of an exoskeleton that has a thin veneer of human skin on it. I don't think that's a proper characterization, but I thought that it was such a wild, left field suggestion that it really broke open how I thought about the creature. He then suggested something like, what if the bones were sort of like Groot's limbs, from Avengers, sort of tangled vines that become these tentacles when the transformation is occurring. The question for Mark and for any special effects supervisor that's coming on board is, how can we pack a ton of special effects quality into a tiny budget? And so these questions really helped break open my concept of the monster, but also it reminded me that I need to be very specific with how everything is going to proceed during the transformation, but also how the creature just operates in everyday life. He also had a lot of great suggestions. Then he suggested that the transformation of the creature was an exothermic reaction, which means giving off a lot of heat. Usually when there's a chemical reaction, there is a byproduct of heat. Just look at how fire and wood burn. That is a chemical reaction. And the two main byproducts are heat and light. And so this creature, when it's transforming, is an exothermic reaction. And I did intuit that it would be exothermic. Part of the transformation is that the creature's skin boils and bubbles off and sloughs off like a bad sunburn. I would like to think that that was me intuiting the fact that this would be an exothermic reaction, that the body would be going through such a tremendous and rapid change that it would be giving off a lot of heat. And this led to a wonderful suggestion that if it's exothermic, it would be releasing a lot of steam, and that presents an opportunity to hide the creature. Because like I said before, we have to pack a lot of effects, a lot of high quality effects and storytelling into a tiny, tiny budget. And one of the ways you do that with special effects is to hide the things that you don't want to show the audience. And because Mark is not only a special effects supervisor, but also a special effects cinematographer, he really understands that. And that suggestion of the steam really broke open another method to hide the creature other than what in my mind is the original idea is a shower curtain. I mean, it could just be he gets into a shower, his skin's falling off, his face is splitting open, steam's coming off him, he turns on the shower, even more steam from the hot water, and voila, you've got a veil of steam. You've got this undulating, amorphous device to hide a creature that is itself amorphous. I just thought it was a great suggestion. It really helped elevate what could be a great scene in my mind. Speaking with Mark really helped me think a little more deeply about the character and the transformation. And something else that he said that really stuck with me was that special effects and visual effects are not an improvisational art form. You can't improvise, you can't change on the fly per se about how the effect is going to transpire. The effects are meticulously designed from beginning to end because you can't waste money on effects. They are so expensive that you have to know exactly what you need for every shot. And maybe that goes without saying, but it's good to hear a reminder that I need to be planning more fully with these things. So when Neil DeMonte, a wonderful storyboard artist and comic book artist that I mentioned in the last couple of vlogs, is going to come on board, I think that that's the scene that I need to storyboard with him. I'm just going to focus on the transformation beat by beat. But I think that's also going to require having the special effects supervisor on board. But if I can't, I'm going to proceed anyway. To give you some idea of how much this effect should cost, I spoke to a special effects supervisor some months ago. His name is Vincent Guastini. Vincent had suggested that a conservative estimate for the effects that I wanted for maybe 2 minutes of screen time, I mean maybe 2 minutes of screen time, was about $50,000, conservatively. So if we were talking traditionally, God, this effect could cost $100,000 or more dollars just to make it sell. So you can see the challenge that I'm up against, that our team is going to be up against. How do we create a series of special effects that really sells and looks like we spent $100,000 on it, but obviously spent only like $2,000 or $4,000 on it? So this is a tremendous challenge, which is why we have to spend so much time planning every shot. So I'm going to get Neil in here sometime soon. We'll do some live storyboarding and we'll talk to him about his process and his art form. And we're going to beat out every single bit of information that we are going to need in order to demonstrate the transformation of the creature from moment to moment. And we can throw things out, but if we don't plan in detail now, we are going to be screwed when the time comes to shoot. We have such a great challenge ahead of us, and I am thrilled to try and pull it off. If we can pull it off, it's going to be a coup. It's going to look fantastic. It's going to sell the film. It's really going to cement this thing in reality. Sadly, Mark can't come on board as my special effects supervisor, but he has agreed to sort of stay on board as a consultant of sorts, so I can call him if I have any questions, if I have any concerns, just whatever. He'd be happy to just talk with me about the process and flesh out the creature in the world a little bit. And it's nice to have that kind of experience in my pocket, if you will, because this is going to be a huge challenge for myself and my team. That's it for Changelings today. Have a good night, everybody, and I will see you tomorrow.